This is Marilyn Lohman, Service Hydrologist at WFO Pendleton. Thanks for joining me. We'll be looking at the current snowpack conditions and the expected water supply for spring and summer of 2018. This is a map of measurements of the snow water equivalent or amount of water being held in the snowpack as of February 1st, 2018 for the basins across the state of Washington. From this map, produced by the Natural Resource Conservation Service, amounts range from 95 to 100% of normal in the upper and lower Yakima basins. The lower Snake Basin was showing 99% of normal. However, within this basin, the Walla Walla Basin had only 60% of normal. We'll look at some individual stations across the area. These charts show the snow water equivalent, or water held in the snow, for the water year October through September. The blue line is the maximum observed and the red line the minimum. Green line is average. Using these charts, we can see how the snow water equivalent accumulates throughout the winter and spring and then compare it to average. This site, the Touchet Snotel site, is in the Walla Walla Basin around 5,500 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack has increased fairly steadily throughout the month of January, but has seen a sharp decrease and continues to be near normal. The Sassy Ridge Snowtail site is located in the upper Yakima Basin at 4,200 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack had a steady increase through much of January and is near normal. The Bumping Ridge Snowtail site is at 4,600 feet in the central Washington Cascades. Looking at the black line, the snowpack also had a steady accumulation through January and is near normal. Across Oregon, the snowpack has been significantly less than Washington. Looking at the snow water equivalent map from the NRCS as of February 1st, we can see that statewide snow water equivalent is well below normal. Amounts range from around 49% in the Deschutes and Crooked Basins to 70% in normal for the northeast corner of Oregon. We'll take a look at some individual sites across the region. For the Northern Cascades of Oregon, the Red Hill Snowtail is at elevation 4,400 feet. Looking at the black line, the current year observation, this site has seen only small accumulations during the month and is well below normal. In the Upper Deschutes Basin, the Three Creek Meadows Snowtail site is at about 5,600 feet. Looking at the solid black line, we can see that this location has seen little accumulation and is well below normal, near the minimum observed for this time of year. In the John Day Basin, we can look at the Blue Mountain Springs Snowtail site at 5,900 feet. There were some small increases throughout the month, but the snow amounts remained well below normal and are also near the minimum observed for this location. For the Umatilla Basin in the Blue Mountains, we can look at the High Ridge site at 4,900 feet. The northern Blue Mountains are faring slightly better than the rest of Oregon. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack did see an increase throughout the month, but remains below normal. And in the Grande Ronde Basin, the Moss Springs Snowtail site is at 5,800 feet. Looking at the black line, the snowpack increased steadily throughout the much of January, but continues to be slightly below normal. The Northwest River Forecast Center uses Ensemble Stream Flow Prediction, or ESP, generated forecasts as the official water supply method. The 30-year runoff normals covering the years 1981 through 2010 are being used. New ESP forecasts will be published on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website daily. For updated forecasts and more information on ESP forecasting, please see the River Forecast Center's website at the address given. This map from the Northwest River Forecast Center shows a snapshot of the water supply forecast for the coming season. As of February 9, 2018, the water supply for the Pacific Northwest looks to be near normal over much of Washington, with below normal water supplies for most of Oregon. We'll look at several stations within the area for a little more detail. For the Yakima River system, we'll look at the Yakima River near Parker. Looking at the plot, the solid green line is the 30-year normal. The plots show an entire range of forecast values, with the blue dot, the 50th percentile, our most likely value. We'll be using that 50th percentile and comparing it to normal. The volume forecast for the Yakima River near Parker for the period April through September is expected to be right at normal with around 103%. The forecasted volume of water, the blue dot, for the Grande Ronde River near Troy is expected to be below normal at about 81%. The value has decreased from 88% of normal seen back in January. These forecasts take into account the expected precipitation for the next 10 days and normal precipitation through the rest of the period. For the Umatilla River at Pendleton for the period April through September, the volume forecast is expected to be about 77% of normal. Once again, these forecasts take into account the current 10-day forecast and normal precipitation through the rest of the season. The Columbia River at the Dalles is an indicator for the entire Columbia Basin. Once again, we're looking at the average plotted in green, with the most likely value the blue dot. The volume for the April through September period has risen to 110% of normal. This is due to the higher than normal snowpack seen in northern Idaho and western Montana. The previous seen plots and additional water supply locations are available in an interactive form on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website at the address listed on the concluding slide. The three-month outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for the rest of February, March, and then April shows increased chances of below normal temperatures and above normal precipitation. Here are the web addresses of the Northwest River Forecast Center where you can get additional and updated water supply forecasts. Please join me again in March as we continue to look at the snowpack and water supply conditions. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please contact me by phone or email.